Hi, Vanessa. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Yeah, I'm very good. Nice to talk to you. I've been enjoying the new music.
That's great.
So, like, you've been in this band over a decade now, right?
Yeah.
So, what was your idea for the band when you were starting out, and how is that different or not to what it is now?
When we started out, we literally were like, we're going to be Metric meets Iron Maiden. And I would say, now we're like, we're just going to fucking make music, rock music that we want to make. So I'd say we've come from definitely feel like, I mean, aside from the genre not being Metric meets Iron Maiden, although it's not that different, to be honest, but like, it's not at all.
I'm trying to think what that would sound like.
What's that?
I'm trying to think what that would sound like.
I think it would be so good. But like, no, we're not that. I would say we're like 20% what that would sound like. But I don't know what that would sound like. I actually feel like that would just sound like Evanescence.
Yeah, we've already got Evanescence, so.
It would be like Evanescence, but like a bit more dancey. Okay. Right? It's like Metric has those like dancey, like a bit more like synthy. Like maybe it would be that. Okay, anyways, but that being said, so I would say now we're just, I think over the 10 years, the biggest shift has been that like, we've stopped trying to be what like we think is trending or what we think we're supposed to be. Like we've spent so long trying to deny that we just like love rock music, because for so long people told us, you know, if your music has a guitar solo in it, no one wants to hear it. Like, remember there was that whole phase where like no one wanted to hear an instrument. Like no one wanted to hear an actual track. So I feel like now we're just kind of like with this album, which is why it's kind of called Against All Odds for one of many reasons. It's just like, we're making the music that we want to make without feeling like we need to conform.
So Against All Odds, what were the odds?
Oh, the odds. Where do we begin the long list of odds? I would say the number one odd is trying to be a musician. Period. Like literally trying to be a working musician is the biggest odd. Like, but within that, there are so many, you know, being a woman in a rock music genre, being a BIPOC woman in a rock music genre, like just like mathematically, the odds are not in our favor ever. Right. Like if there's such a small percentage of us, that's been a really big barrier for us in the industry. We've been told to our faces, people don't want to hear women in rock. We've been told they won't play our music because their listeners don't want to hear women and they can't sell ads. Like that stuff has been said to us time and time again. So that's like kind of a bit of an obvious one, but other odds I would say are just trying not to lose our minds, you know, trying not to feel like we can't be ourselves, trying to not cave to the pressure of having to conforming to trends like TikTok and posting every day and your worth being measured by how many likes you get. An entire pandemic is an odd, you know, just, I think there have been so many points. Oh, I don't know if you know this, but me and David dated for 4 years in the middle of that, then broke up in the middle of it. And that like, that was a huge odd, you know, like there's, I'm sure everyone has these in their lives, but for us, it is that feeling of like against all odds, against so many people who kind of like didn't believe in us and told us we weren't going to make it, or weren't what the industry wanted to hear, or we should do something different or wear something different. We're still here and we're putting out our best work ever. And we feel more passionate about this now than ever. And I think we feel more like the world sort of needs music more than ever now. Like that is in very many circles and communities, like the only thing that isn't divisive. Like it's like people can have like such different opinions, but at least like agree that like this band in front of them rocks right now. So yeah. I guess there's all sorts of things. I get like, not to be, I sound negative, but like the world, you know, I think the world has showcased over the past few years, especially like how angry and sad and hurt people really are. And I think like, never mind us personally, but Against All Odds is sort of like a collective feeling. Like Against All Odds, many of us are still fighting for equity. We're still trying to help people feel included and belong. We're still trying to understand how other people feel. Like we're still trying to connect, even though so much has told us like people hate each other.
So speaking to that theme, that explains the title. Does the theme of Against the Odds run through the songs?
Yeah, I would say for sure. Like, I think I'm like mentally going through the track list, but a lot of the stuff we write is about the feeling of rejection we feel in so many different areas of not just music, but in our own lives, right? Like, again, like there is definitely a pervasive theme in the album, especially with songs like Wait For It or Belong, literally. themes of being told you're not good enough and you can't do it, right? Like someone literally being like, just fucking give up, right? Like, don't quit your day job. Like, go stick to your zone. Like, don't try and like kind of draw without the, you know, outside the lines. So those themes for sure run through a lot of the songs, and they're universal themes. Like, I'm sure you feel that in areas of your own life, right? There are things you've probably told to like, you're not good at, or you should just not even bother trying. So the themes of the album are not just like speaking to that feeling, but they're hopefully like a pep talk for everyone to be like, fuck the haters. Like, you know, you don't have to listen to that, and or you can use that as fuel for your fire. You know, like often that's a bit more of a cynical approach, but like how to actually make productive use of those feelings and turn to something them into something cathartic and something that will help other people. Like, we hope these songs help other people that feel that way.
Yeah, for sure. So over the last 10 years or slightly more of being in the band, we talked about the odds that you're fighting against, but there must have been moments there that have kind of encouraged you and like made you think, actually, this is what we should be doing. Are there any standout moments where you're like, this is working?
For sure. I think that's so important to bring up. I literally like wrote that, and I wrote the last place in my journal today before moving to a new journal. And I literally wrote something like that. I was like, this past month has been so tough and there have been so many moments of darkness, but like, you know, there are so many moments of light, and it's so important to not just let those lights be little flashes, like, you know, as though you saw like a shooting star or something, and then or a flash of lightning. Like, it's important to really remember that those moments of light are there, like as fleeting as they might be, like they always seem small in comparison to the dark sky. The dark sky always seems bigger, but like, that's not necessarily true. So like a moment just happened, even like we played a show on Saturday night. It was a last show of our summer tour. And it was fine. Like, I was like in the weird, you know, when I had one of those moods being like, no one cares. Like, oh my God, like whatever. And after our show, this guy just came up to us and he said, you guys were magnificent. And I was like, oh, thanks, whatever. And he said, no, listen, I want you to know you guys are the real deal. And he just was like, that's all he said. And it was just like, it was the exact thing I needed to hear. You know what I mean? Like, he was just like an old school rocker dude. And he was like, I'm like super into like rock. I used to be in a rock band. Like, he's like, I haven't flapped with my hands over my head since 1982. Like, you guys made me do that. And I was like, I need to hang on to that moment. You know, like, it's easy to be like, oh, that's just one guy or that's just whatever. But like, that's who we're doing it for, each individual person that we can affect with our music. And like, his positive affirmation of our music is not less important than someone else saying, hey, no one wants to hear your guitar solo. Like, they're both equal, you know, or like his is more important, you know? So I think stuff like that. But then there have been like big moments. Like, we were selected to open for Bon Jovi in 2018 out of hundreds of applicants. Like, or, you know, we had the best touring summer ever this past summer. Like, we played amazing festivals. We played in front of tons of fans. We've never sold this much merch. Like, we've been added to all these editorial playlists. But I was saying to David, like, we are so sick as a society, because like, it's like we're addicts, right? Like, the first time we got added to a Spotify playlist, it was like in January with One Pill. It got added to like two Spotify editorials, and we were like freaking out. Like, we were like going insane. And then it's like, you get added to it again and you're like excited. Then you get added to it again for your next single, and you're like, I wonder when they're going to add us to more playlists, right? Like, it's so crazy that like, you have to constantly remind yourself, as you're saying, like, all those moments of validation are like just as important as the first time they happen. But I think it's like a real struggle, because like, that's the way our society is designed. That's the way capitalism is designed. Like, you're always supposed to want more. It's never enough, that kind of thing. And it's like pretty hard to remember that.
But I think especially with artists, they're always trying to like get to the next thing. They're trying, they're never satisfied. And that's part of what makes them an artist. And hopefully that's what part of what makes them a successful artist in whichever way you want to define success. Like, I don't know anybody who's an artist. Like, I'm a photographer. I know people who are, they make movies. I know musicians. And I don't know a single one that's ever like, I'm perfectly happy.
Right?
Now. This is exactly what I wanted to achieve. And I've done it.
I know. And it's, you're so right. Cause I mean, you read interviews with like Lady Gaga, even, who's like disappointed she didn't get such and such role or like whatever. And you're like, what the fuck is Lady Gaga complaining about? But I think you're right. It is what drives us as humans, right? To do better and to exceed our own expectations for sure. It's just like, there's such a fine line between like when that's a healthy feeling and a productive feeling. And when then it's like, when it's just like a self-defeating feeling, right? Like, it's like, how do you, I think I'm constantly working on this through like meditation and self-help, is just like, how do you still be ambitious and strive for more while being content and satisfied and grateful for where you're at? It's like, how do you toe that line?
And talking about the rock music thing, people saying nobody wants to hear guitars. I heard an interview with another band recently and they were being told exactly the same thing. Like, nobody's interested in rock music anymore. And that band was Muse.
Oh my God, I love that, because sometimes we compare ourselves to Muse. So that feels really cool.
Yeah. And people,
I know,
are
it's
telling them that.
Yeah, I know. It's so crazy. Like, and also like, no one knows anything and trends change every second. And now rock music is really cool. So we have like 2 minutes to shine right now.
Yeah. Okay. So rock music is cool. What's exciting you in the world of rock music these days?
Oh my God. I feel like this is such an exciting time, because I really have noticed, like you said, you know, we've been in the band for, I think it's 11 years now. And there was a time, it's like so much has changed and so much has stayed the same at the same time. So I want to first acknowledge that, like, there are still, for example, festival bills that are all men. I played a few festivals this summer that were specifically rock music where I was the only woman on the bill, but I've played a bunch of them where it was like 30, 40% women. Like, it's, things are really changing. And like, and also like, it's so exciting to watch all these new bands forming and emerging, like all these new artists with really diverse band lineups, like not just women, like it's just like, it's not only white cis dudes in these bands and they're good. Like, you know, like Plush or Thunder Mother. Those are just the two that I'm really obsessed with right now. They're
I just interviewed Thunder Mother.
What?
Yeah.
Oh my God. Tell them they need to let us open for them. I'm obsessed. with them. I love that 80s hair metal rock. Like, I just love that style so much. I would love to write a song with them. Like, I don't even know how to write a song like that, but I think it'd be so cool. But yeah, like, you're really, it's like, I remember like 4 years ago when like the Beaches really like started taking center stage and everyone was like, oh my God, like all girls, like what? Like, it was really a phenomenon. And now it's like, there are tons of not just female fronted bands, but bands that are like all non-male, or like there's only one guy in the group. Like, I that to me is really, really exciting, because there are so many points where I just feel like shit is never going to change and it's just always going to stay the same and the same people are going to be gatekeepers, and I see that changing. So I think that's really cool. I think that's the main thing probably interesting me in rock. And I mean, just the fact that like I'm seeing more of it because it's around more and now it's, you know, people have decided it's cool again. I love that this particular style of rock is like making a comeback, which is like that 90s grunge rock. Like, I really like that Our Lady Peace kind of sound. I love that. And I just, yeah, I think those are probably the things that are exciting me, is that you're seeing a real change and a more welcoming space and like more people being involved, which just means we're gonna, like, I can't wait to see what rock music is like in 5 years, because you know there are now more diverse people creating it, which I think is cool.
Okay, so last question, if you could put together the ultimate rock bands with people alive or dead, who would you have in your band?
Oh my God, that's a real tough question. Okay, let's think. Okay. Okay. I feel like, first of all, like the sound I would want the bit, because really, I think my just like favorite sound is 80s hair. Like, that's what I want to hear the most. Like, that's like what gets me going the most. So I think I would want like those people in it. But like now I don't know. I'm also like really not good at this because I don't know anyone's names or like, my first thought is I actually think Lady Gaga needs to be in the band. So I actually think she would be the vocalist. Like, I think she'd be the singer and she would go full 80s hair metal. Like, so like she'd be in there somewhere.
I think she'd be into that.
I think she'd totally be into it. Now, the other issue is like, I don't know anything basically about bass players or drummers. So I think my band would have like four guitarists and like nothing. Cause I don't even know like who I'd pick. I feel so pressured right now.
Sorry,
but I'm thinking, no, it's okay. I'm thinking, and I don't even like, I'm just the funniest person to ask. Cause David would actually have like a full answer. Whereas I'm like, I don't know, like the drummer from Def Leppard.
Rick Allen.
Sure. but like, I don't like, based on what am I saying that? I don't know.
Well, if anybody has got through against the odds, that's the guy.
Right? Okay, so fine. Let's put him in the band. Okay, so he's going to go in the band. Lady Gaga. Who are some amazing guitarists? Like,
so many.
Yeah, but like, that's what you're saying. I like, it all blurs into one. Like, I just see a band. Like, I don't know the individual guitarists. Like, give me some ideas. Who's like a sick shredding guitarist?
I would put somebody like Slash in that band, maybe.
Yeah. Yeah. I feel like that's the thing. I'm also only just picturing hair. Like, I kind of wanted to say Sebastian Bach, but like, no, because I don't like him as a human. But like, you know what I'm saying?
I can give you a good Sebastian backstory from when I met him, which would make you like him probably less.
Wait, we need some guitar. Oh my God. I know what bass player I want. I want the bass player from Danko Jones's band.
Oh, okay.
He's like my favorite bass player, like when I've seen him. But like, again, like based on what? Like, I don't even have like, I mean, he's really fun, but is he like, actually, no, I think I'll go with him. And I need a couple of guitarists here. I'm also like very concerned about how diverse my band is. Like, I'm like, okay, hold on. Who do we have?
No, I wasn't going to say anything. No,
like, yet. That's what I'm thinking.
You've got Lady Gaga in there.
Yeah, but everyone's white in this band so far. What guitar? I mean, I bet you the guitarists in Thunder Month are really good, but I don't actually know. But
they're definitely entertaining.
Well, that's what the band is about. Oh my God. Hold on a second. Are we using the drummer from Def Leppard or Motley Crue? No, Def Leppard, because the Against All Odds. Okay. And that's what the band would be called. It would be called Against All Odds, the band, right? Okay, so we can have the guitarist from the Thunder Mother, because yeah, they have to be entertaining. Like, they have to be like so whack. And I don't know what else we're gonna put in this band. We need another guitarist. Do they have two guitarists, Thunder Mother?
It's up to you. Well, yeah, they do. I think they have. Yeah, they have two guitars, bass, and drums.
Oh, I'm so stressed out about this fictional band. Which is like, but really, most of it is because I don't like. Know what any bands are made up of. Like, I don't know any of this stuff. I'm just like, Def Leppard is a band. I don't know. I couldn't even tell you the singer's name. Who's the singer? Like, I don't even know. I have no clue.
Jim Elliot.
Had no idea. I would not know that. I wouldn't even recognize him on the street. Okay. So who plays guitar? Who plays guitar? What's his name from Rage Against the Machine?
Tom Morello.
That's going to be the other guitarist. There. This is a sick band. Okay. So we have Lady Gaga. Okay. Lady Gaga, guitarist from Thunder Mother. Tom Morello is the other guitarist, bass player from Danko Jones, drummer from Def Leppard. I think that's looking pretty good.
Yeah, that'd be a great band to watch, I think.
And then I'm the guitarist.
Okay, yeah.
I'm the guitarist and the co-lead singer with Lady Gaga.
Okay, I can see that.
God, that question took like 10 minutes to answer.
Okay. Well, it's been an absolute pleasure talking to you. What's going to be happening after the album comes out for you guys?
After the album comes up, world domination, taking over the world. We have a little bit of a tour plan. And then we're like, we have a surprise, a post-album surprise that might involve the holidays. And that's all I can tell you.
Okay.
But I will say the album will not be the last you will hear of us this year.
Wow, you are prolific at the moment. Great. Well, I look forward to that as well, whatever you have coming around the corner. But in the meantime, really nice chatting to you, and I hope to see you live sometime.
Yes. Oh my gosh, for sure. Thank you so much for your support, and you will definitely see us live.